Here comes a fashion designer, a very sort of undiscovered artist, some drummers, some performing artists, who are all resources who are within CFN links, working, teaching our young people English, science and maths every day, 36 weeks in a year. So we put these resources together and we felt that young people, out of the wish list that they put to us, we can create one, something called iPerform, which means that young people come together as to create their own story in performing arts. And then from that also we pick up another sort of element, which was what we call the eye expression, whereby young people can express themselves in the visual arts and then create the environment within, which is what we've now displayed upstairs in an exhibition. We also looked at something that can be very energetic, but also creating some environment for young people where they can express yourself in movement. And movements actually have a very common link. Can I have some noise there? Noise is there somewhere. I get distracted by noise, I'm sorry. Is it this thing here? Sorry. Okay. Movement and dancing is something that these days we talk about. STEM, which we're trying to guide young people through science and technology. Therefore, movement becomes very, very key. Dancing creates a lot of movement and reactions in terms of how we move. We also look at things around what else can we do in terms of the mind and that, and we put together something called yoga, eye focus. And then there's another one which I've missed, probably something else we started on eye. Eye perform, eye expression, I upcycle, which then brought fashion into being. So what we did was we literally tried to create anything, things for young people. I upcycle was very, very, we were very, very lucky to pull in a very creative designer, also undiscovered, but have their own label called Besto Ilan. And if you Google that, you'll be surprised the creative sort of work that she's been doing. And she devoted her time and then gave us something back to the community, which in community development, where we call it social responsibility. So Azuma Akasin gave her time for that purpose. Okay, so we are here today to celebrate 5 weeks we've managed to pull together all the sort of skills and talent from young people, which for some of you who has been upstairs, you can actually see the talent and what young people have put together. And these are all from Lambeth. And when Lambeth speaks about their vision today, Lambeth talks about a cooperative power. What does it really mean, cooperative power? Co-production, it comes up every time we speak about it. All we've done here is that we've brought the young people together. They've told us what they want to do. And we've encouraged them, helped them build the confidence to do that. And what we're going to do this evening is part of the whole process, where we are going to have young people performing their arts through the performing arts and drumming and dancing. Some of the time we are going to sort of have to build as we go along. We were expecting young Lambeth here. Young Lambeth, who is Zoe and Chris. Do you want to come up here and then sort of...
Yay!
If I get a big hand for young Lambeth. They were actually the pioneers of all this. They funded the program. And have we got anybody from the RMOs? RMOs, Angell Town, Blenheim Garden. Okay. These are the people who actually created the problem, created the project, and they funded the project. And what we find here is that a group of young people who are making decisions about funding, millions of pounds, and they make decisions about who get it. And CFL and Links, we were very lucky and very fortunate to be given the money to create what we're going to see today. Zoe, would you like to say something today?
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, good. Evening, everyone.
Evening.
I'm Zoe, as I
said. I'm Reese.
So we're from Young Lambeth Co-op. Reese is one of our apprentices, and I work as community engagement worker. And be here tonight because we've actually been, not only have we witnessed some of the sessions that have happened this summer and putting this together, but we've visited quite a few different after-school projects or CEF links across Lambeth. So we've been able to see firsthand the amazing work that they do with our local young people. And really, that's what Young Lambeth Co-op is all about. It's all about giving young people the chance to do things in their community that they may not have necessarily been able to do before. So I don't know if you know much about Young Lambeth Co-op, but we're a new organisation, about a year old now, but we're in formation with the council and the community for about 2 years before that. And the idea was really to give the budget of youth services, which is almost £9 million for the next few years, to put that into the hands of the community. So what the Young Lambeth Co-op is its own separate organisation from the council. It's, as Christian was talking about, the whole idea of being a cooperative borough. They've set us up as a separate organisation. So anyone can sign up and be a member, and some of our Young Lambeth Co-op members actually heard about this project that Christian and his team presented to some of our young members. They heard about the project and thought it was so great that they should actually get funding. So that meant local people from the community chose this project for funding, and that's how we work. So we actually love visiting CEF Links, and I can't even count how many times we've been to different projects. But CEF Links are one of the prime examples in Lambeth of how, when you speak to young people and reach out to them, some of them, or the majority of them, actually have ideas of their own and have things that they know that they want to do in their free time. So it's so exciting to see this organisation being able to work with Young Lambeth Co-op in putting the power in the hands of the young people. Really listening to them, and not just listening to them, but taking forward in action what it is that they want to do. So I'm looking forward to what we're about to see today, knowing that it was chosen by young people as their favourite activities. And yeah, we're just grateful to be here. If anyone wants to find out more about what we're about, we're going to be here. Come say hi to us. If you'd like to sign up, you can sign up on our website, younglambethco-op.co.uk. Come speak to us today. Yeah, thanks for having us. Thanks, Christian.
We are going to start and we are going to announce the first program. So please sit tight, put your seatbelts on. We're not flying to Malaga, we're in Brixton. Let's go.
Hi, good evening. My name is Navdet. I'm the chair of the organisation and I want to open up our showcase and our wonderful, fabulous time that I'd like you to come and enjoy the journey with us. So I'm going to open up. We'll introduce you to Azuma, who will be introducing the catwalk. Can we give a cheer?
Hello, hi everyone. My name's Azuma, and I am the teacher on the iUpcycle program. See, what you'll find, we're going to do a catwalk today, but I'll give you a little background about what iUpcycling is. Basically, we invited all the young people to bring in old garments, anything old, fabric-wise, that we can reclaim and recreate something new. So what you'll find once you see the catwalk, what you're gonna see is a diverse range of clothes, fabric use. We introduce fabric painting, accessorized with buttons and beading. So we created something new, basically. So, all that's left to say is enjoy the catwalk.
Oh, created a storyboard. In their group, they voted for their favourite story, and we turned that into a play. And the kids then, they wrote the script for the play, so they wrote the scripts themselves, they wrote poetry to narrate the play, and then they chose which songs they'd like to sing and dance to as well. So they've created these plays, with their ideas, and hopefully you'll like them. So first up, we've got Loughborough, and their play is called The Magic of Objects. Okay, so we'll just grab the Loughborough kids and we'll be with you. Enjoy the show. The Magic of Objects, a story of imagination and belief by I Perform at Loughborough. Scene one, Princess enters the stage and looks down at her shoes.
I need some new shoes. These shoes are old and worn. I'll take the tube into Central today and see what I can find. I've heard they have some great sales at the moment.
Princess exits stage, then re-enters. She's now in Central trying on shoes in Topshop. She finds a pair that are perfect and looks at them in amazement and excitement. The shop assistant enters and walks up to the princess.
Oh yes, they are really cool and very comfortable too. Let me fix your size for you.
Size 2, please.
The shop assistant exits the stage, taking a single shoe with her. She then re-enters with the complete pair of shoes and hands them to the princess.
There you go, madam. I'll leave you to try them on. Have a walk around, see how they feel. Any questions, just give me a shout.
Great, thank you.
The shop assistant exits the stage. The princess tries shoes on, but something extraordinary happens, and the shoe begins to speak.
The princess met a talking shoe. She could not believe that it was true.
The princess tries on the shoe, but something extraordinary happens and the shoe begins to speak. Shoe enters.
Hey you, don't put me on your smelly, stinky feet. I'm sick of all these customers picking me up, squeezing me, and putting me on their smelly, stinky feet.
The princess gasps in shock and looks down at the shoes.
Was that you that spoke?
Yes, of course it was me who spoke. Who did you think it was?
Wow, I'm terribly sorry for upsetting you.
The princess takes off the shoes and walks off stage looking sad and disappointed. The ball enters the stage. Princess re-enters walking into a toy shop this time and picks up a bright ball. She begins to bounce the ball when it starts to speak too.
Hey you, stop bouncing me, put me down. I have such an awful headache from children bouncing me up and down all day long.
The princess looks confused and hesitating says,
Did you just say that?
Yes, gosh, why is everyone always so surprised when I...
The princess screams and runs off the stage. All cast enter and dance to Big Brothers. Big Brothers. stage too. Can we have our fish on stage? Fish enters stage. The princess re-enters, walking into the market this time. She's hungry. She looks at the fish, thinking about dinner. She lifts up the fish when it also starts to speak.
Put me down. People have been picking me up all day long.
Princess shakes her head and throws her arms in the air and runs off the stage. She thinks she's going crazy. Scene 4. Princess returns to stage and flops back onto her bed. She's tired and scared. No one believes her that all these things are talking.
Oh my, what a day. I'm sure my shoes fall and fish come to me, but nobody believes me.
Then the bed speaks from offside the stage.
That's the most inconceivable thing I ever heard. What a crazy thing to say.
The princess sits bolt upright, puts her head on her hands and shakes her head with exhaustion and confusion. The end. Cast return to stage.
I wish I could fly away somewhere new.
I'm not afraid to. poems on imaginary places. So they thought of an imaginary place, they wrote some words about it, and then they formed it into a poem. I was really, really impressed with them. I hope you will be too. Thank you.
Our imaginary places with words and poems that were inspired by them. Angel Time, I perform. My name is Rianne and I am 9 years old. I was looking at a white fluffy cloud when someone shouted out loud. Out of nowhere came a boy, which was as small as a toy. The boy was hiding in the trees when he was surrounded by some buzzing bees. I saw a pretty flower, which had some magical power. I was looking at a white fluffy cloud.
Thank you. My name is Amin and I'm 10. It was that tree, the tree in the middle of nowhere. It was little lonely because the island was peopleless and cloudless, but positively clear. The withering green leaves were still lush as they were. Due to the ancient heavy sky wind, the leaves could bear. The beaming, shining, shimmering, sunny sun beams down on the grass, which is actually very red, quite amazing.
Thank you. They're fantastic. And the good thing about this is that these set of people is a mixture of all different estates. So it's fantastic to see people stay come together and play together.
I'm Amadi, I was running iFocus. What the children are going to show you today, they're just going to do a short game to show you the postures that they've learned. So they're not going to do a yoga sequence, but during the game you'll see some of the postures that they've learned during the week.
Yogi says deeper breathe.
Doing nothing.
In the third islands of Basel, there was a joyful chorus in the air. As the trio of bear dogs their way to the safari, there was a smile on their faces.
Today is really boring. Hey, let's go to the safari.
They reach the safari and are ready to have fun. The safari animals come on stage and join the teddies. The teddies start dancing with joy as they're excited about their trip that's to come.
Thank you.
children is their own expression using different tools and materials that was also delivered by CEF and Link staff. And one of CEF Link staff is the facilitator called Susanna, who is managing it as a facilitator. And she's going to talk just for a couple of minutes of some of the things that was displayed upstairs, okay? Thank you. Thank you very much. Hello, good evening. How are you? Is it okay? Are you enjoying?
Yes, wonderful. My name is Susana Valcarte. I'm from Spain. I am an artist, but a younger artist, because I started my art in 2009. And I have now a wonderful, incredible opportunity like this. Nablet and Christian, this association gave me this opportunity for me in the summertime a workshop in art. And this is the result. You can see upstairs a lot of jobs. The student was wonderful. Thank you very much for the parents for bringing their children here with us and enjoy and learn a lot of things. In this 5 weeks, we learned different things, different techniques. We start with my art because I am an artist and I like the children know my art, my technique. All time. In each session, I have 3 steps. The first step is introduce the artist. In this case, will be Susana Valcarce, or Joan Miró, or Kandinsky, because sometimes we paint with music. We use different materials, different techniques. We miss color. I love the children, and I think it's important to be totally free. They can follow some instruction. I can say, okay, you have to do this, that. But at the end, it's wonderful what students show their concern, their thoughts. No, it's important to show and know exactly this child feel or think about art. We are lucky because we went to different places in trip art, for example, National Gallery, other gallery in Camberwell. And this gives the opportunity to see other kind of art, a contemporary art. And the children can observe this art one-to-one, this canvas. And after this, they can paint and show their thoughts and paper themselves. For me, it was a wonderful experience because for me, feeling is important in art. This is an example. Thank you so much for the parents. They're very important because parents bring the children here. And thank you very much for the association for bringing this opportunity. And I hope my wish is the next summertime will be here. But all the things I have to see before I finish my speech. Thank you very much with all my heart to Andy, to Tundi, to Des, to Mary, to Sarah. I forget to Leo. Leo is not here. Thank you very much, Nadia, what is Nadia? Here the same. Thank you very much for your help because your help was inestimable for me. Thank you very much for all. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Roupell. Scene one. Heidi enters. She sees the mirror on the wall. She got upset and made an angry face.
That's not fair! I want to be the prettiest of them all!
Heidi smashes the mirror in anger with both fists. She broke the mirror, but it came back, and she was stuck inside it. She screamed and cried and banged her fists, but no one can help her out of it.
Thank you.
its mirrorland and enters Heidi's bedroom as her reflection. Heidi continues to silently scream, "Let me out!" and bangs on the mirror. The mirror looks back at Heidi with disappointment. She's lost and scared in Mirrorland forever, on her own. No friends, no family, nobody to play with. She is really all alone. Mirror character?
Little girl, you must learn to understand that everyone is beautiful in their own way. The only way you will understand this by spending a very long time in Mirrorland, reflecting your thoughts and yourself in different ways.
Yeah. Heidi drops to her knees and continues to cry, and mimes, "I'm sorry."
Ladies and gentlemen, buenas tardes, buenas tardes, buenas noches. I know it's not buenas noches, good night, but I want to say good evening to you guys in Spanish because habla un pequeño in español. Very, very small Spanish because I speak French and I'm a linguist. Education, education, education. Diversity, diversity, diversity. I'm so glad and I'd like to thank Christian Johnson, Navlet Williams, and all the CEF Link staff for an amazing day today. I was absolutely gobsmacked at what you guys have achieved, and you children, congratulations. You all deserve to give each other a big clap. Come on, big yourselves up, come on. You have all been absolutely brilliant. And Lambeth Council will know this, let me assure you. As an ex-Lambeth councillor, still active in the community, let's make history here. Number one, in 1992, I became the Deputy Mayor of Lambeth. In 1993, I became the first Black Lady Mayor of Lambeth. Now, what I want you guys to know, and I'll make my declaration tonight, and it will go in the newspapers, I'm not bothered. I want to declare to you that I'm going to stand as a member of the European Parliament because we do not have any Black MEPs, okay? Okay. Okay, so that's my declaration. Okay. What I've seen today and what CEF Links has achieved is amazing. It's been going for 4 years, and to see that some of the children here belong to the normal programme and some of you are part of the summer programme. Have you enjoyed your summer? Yeah. Has it been productive? Yeah. And the children that normally go, how's Links going for you, CEF Links? Is that great? Yeah. Do you find you're learning a great deal? Excellent. Okay. Well, I'm glad to see this organisation providing after-school care and summer care in education for our children. At the end of the day, as you all know, we will not progress in society without decent education. So if we need to provide extra support for our children after school, then so be it. And I hope to God that Lambeth Council will continue in this vein. But not only Lambeth Council, I hope to be doing some work on fundraising with CEF and Links to try and make sure that we bring European funding to our children here in Brixton and throughout the borough. As I noticed, there are 5 areas of operation by CEF Links, and one of them is in the neighbourhood where I was a councillor, which is Roupell. Roupell Estate was certainly an area I had great interest in as a councillor in Lambeth. I'm so glad CEF Links is doing great works, and I can see a future for CEF Links. It's tutors, it's partners, it's volunteers, and of course the mothers and fathers, the families, and all the wonderful children who are here today who are benefiting from CEF Links. Ladies and gentlemen, I won't take any more of your time, but I wish you all good luck in your future, especially for your children. May God bless you all, and thank you very much. Gracias, muchas. Buenas noches, besos. Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Say goodbye.